Welcome back to STS. If you find today's content helpful or beneficial, please subscribe, like, and or share. In today's tutorial, we need to find the measure of each of the angles listed below. Here we have a diagram that shows two parallel lines indicated by these arrows, and we have two transversals, one transversal T that intersects the parallel lines and transversal V that also intersects the parallel lines. And we're given angles of 78 degrees and an angle of 44 degrees, and we see the missing angles here in red. All right, let's begin. We have vertical angles with 78 degrees and 9, so I know the angle 9 is also 78 degrees. So let's put 78 degrees here and also put it down here. All right, we also know that angle 44 and angle 11 are also vertical, so this here is also 44 degrees and angle 11 is 44 degrees. See what else can we find pretty quickly. We have corresponding angles, so this angle here corresponds with this angle here, so angle 2 is 78 degrees, so we place 78 degrees here. And again, we have some more vertical angles, so angle 4 is also 78 degrees. Oops, so let's fix that. 4 is 78 degrees. Notice that we have a triangle here, and remember that the interior angles of a triangle always add up to 180 degrees, so we have two of the angles, so we can figure out angle 5. So let's add these two angles here together first. So we have 44 plus the 78. Well, 8 plus 4 is 12, 7 and 4 is 11, plus one more is 12, so we have 122. So that's the combined total of these two angles. Now let's take 180 and subtract off the 122. We're going to regroup to make that 7, and this becomes 10. 10 minus 2 is 8, and then 7 minus 2 is 5, and 1 minus 1 is 0. So here we see that angle 5 is 58 degrees, so let's squeeze that in here. So angle 5 is 58. Again, we have vertical angles, so angle 7 is also 58. All right, and let's see what else we have. See what else can we do. We have a linear pair between angles 6 and 7. We know a linear pair adds up to 180 degrees and makes a straight line. So let's do 180 minus the 58. Alright, let's regroup. So here we have 10 minus 8 to give us 2, and 7 minus 5 to give us 2, and here we have 122 for angle 6. Alright, if angle 6 is 122, angle 8 is also 122, and that's because they're vertical angles. Alright, let's see what else can we do here. Alright, we have another linear pair between we can do either angles 1 and 2, or we can do angles 1 and 4. I'll go ahead and do 1 and 2. So we're going to do 180 minus 78. Alright, well, 80 take away 78 is 2. And then I bring down the 1. So here we see this angle 1 here is 102. And we have vertical angles between 1 and 3. So we know that angle 3 is also 102. And okay, let's work on, we're missing 10 and 12. All right, so let's work on that. So let's see what can we do here. All right, well, these three angles here, 12, 44, and 78, those also create a straight line. So I can add these two together and then subtract 180 to figure out what angle 12 is. So we have a 78 plus 44, actually we already have that as 122. And then we do the 180 minus the 122. So here I see that angle 12 has to be 58 degrees. So we place in the 58 right here for angle 12. And angle 12 and angle 10 are vertical, so that means they're also congruent. Alright, and then that there is, and that sums it up. So here we have a set of parallel lines that are intersected by two transversals, and we figured out what all the angles were, or what all the angles are. If you found this content to be helpful, please like, share, and subscribe. And as always, have a great day.